For weeks now, one question looms. Will Rahul Gandhi fight from Amethi? And the suspense continues. 3 days away from nomination deadline, Congress now under pressure to take a call. Kharge says announcement soon.
1 or 2 days you will know that who will be the candidates.
BJP mocks Gandhi's over Amethi suspense.
मेरा मानना है कि इतना कंफ्यूजन रखना ही उनको आत्मविश्वास नहीं है वो दिखाता है.
Gandhi's Amethi conundrum is our top focus on Election Express.
Hello and welcome. You're watching Election Express here on India Today. I'm Akshita Nandagopal. Over the next 1 hour, we round up all of the big election stories of the day. And of course, our focus remains on what's happening in Amethi. There's still no clarity whatsoever. The Congress is tight-lipped. Some seem to be dropping hints that it won't be the Gandhi. Some suggesting that Rahul Gandhi will very much contest. We ensure here over the next 1 hour, we put out the details that we have as far as the Congress's stand on Amethi is concerned. May 3rd is the last date of filing nominations. So in the next 24 to 48 hours max, the Congress will have to come to a decision. Let's begin this broadcast with the headlines. Mega India Today Newsbreak impact. JDS suspense predator Prajwal Revana until SIT report details are out. Home Minister Amit Shah condemns Prajwal, says it's an insult to Nari Shakti and it will not be tolerated. Prime Minister Modi invokes hit film RRR in State of War Telangana, levels RR. Revant Reddy tax jibe at the Chief Minister, says Telangana is fed up of RR tax and Congress made up of five lies.
पीपल आर फिल्म ने पूरी दुनिया में भारत का नाम रोशन किया, लेकिन ये डबल आर टैक्स भारत के लिए शर्मिंदगी बढ़ा रहा है.
Showdown over Amit Shah's doctored video continues. Home Minister lashes out at Congress, calls it a desperate attempt to hold on to power. Three accused arrested so far. Samajwadi Party Neta in the dock for her bizarre vote jihad call. Salman Khurshid's niece seeks social boycott of Muslim BJP voters. BJP hits out, says Maria Alam radicalized by her uncle.
बहुत अकलमंदी के साथ, बहुत जज्बाती न होके, बहुत खामोशी के साथ एक साथ होके वोटों का जिहाद करो, क्योंकि हम सिर्फ वोटों का जिहाद कर सकते हैं.
एडमिरल दिनेश कुमार त्रिपाठी टेक्स चार्ज एज इंडियाज नेवी चीफ सीक्स ब्लेसिंग्स फ्रॉम मदर बिफोर टेकिंग ओवर. And India announces its squad for the T20 World Cup in India Americas. Rohit Sharma to lead as captain. Rishabh Pant and Sanju Samson return. KL Rahul dropped. On May 3rd, 3 days from now, the deadline for the Amethi nomination comes to an end. Smriti Irani filed a nomination yesterday. But who is her challenger? We still don't know. The Congress has yet to announce a candidate from the constituency, which means before May 3rd, they obviously will, but there's going to be no question of any sort of a campaign in Amethi. And amid this, there's endless suspense over whether Rahul Gandhi will actually go ahead and fight from Amethi to avenge his 2019 loss or not. Or will he shift over to Rae Bareli? Will Priyanka Gandhi step in? There are no answers right now. However, sources are telling us that Priyanka Gandhi will not be contesting elections this time. Rahul Gandhi reportedly is expected to take a call very, very soon.
Will he or won't he enter the Amethi battlefield? 3rd May is the last day to file nomination for the Gandhi legacy seat in Uttar Pradesh. And hours before the deadline, there's still no clarity on whether Rahul Gandhi will take on Smriti Irani.
There is no question of my contesting there. But 1 or 2 days, you will know that who will be the candidates.
Sources also tell India Today that Priyanka Gandhi Vadra will not be contesting from neither Raibareli nor Amethi. The confusion over candidates has the local Congress cadre up in arms. They are demanding that a Gandhi contest from Amethi.
In the Congress camp, suspense continues over Raibareli and Amethi. India Today has learnt that any decision on Rahul Gandhi's UP contest could come by Wednesday. It would also be decided soon that whether Rahul Gandhi would actually go to Amethi or switch over to his mother's constituency, Raibareli.
The lack of a decision on Amethi and Raibareli by the Congress has given fresh ammunition to the BJP.
ये मालूम नहीं है मीडिया आज सुबह से दिखा रहा है वो सच है या नहीं है लड़ेंगे या नहीं लड़ेंगे वो भी मुझे मालूम नहीं है मगर मेरा मानना है कि इतना कंफ्यूजन रखना ही उनके उनको आत्मविश्वास नहीं है वो दिखाता है उत्तर प्रदेश में जिस प्रकार की आज स्थिति बनी है वो अपनी परंपरागत सीटें छोड़कर भागे हैं मैं नहीं मानता वो लड़ने की हिम्मत कर पाएंगे
Rahul's Amethi nemesis Smriti Irani hurled Namdar jibe at the Gandhi sign.
Modi ki guarantee lekar Amethi ki dhara par lad rahe hain. Amethi mein jab jo bhi Congress ka pratyashi aayega unko nishchit roop se jawab dena padega ki 15 saal lapata sansad ke parivar mein satta thi kendra mein. Tabhi sare kaam kyun nahi hue? Apne 5 saal ke kaam aur unke 15 saal ke agar wo ek bhi kaam girwana shuru kare to isi ke beech mein mujhe lagta hai ye chunav comparison ka एक नामदार का गायब होना और कामदार का काम
उत्तर प्रदेश बीजेपी लीडर्स हैव ऑलरेडी डिक्लेयर्ड दैट अमेठी विल बी अ नो कंटेस्ट फाइट
राज्य में अमेठी रायबरेली मैनपुरी सहित सभी 80 सीटों पर बीजेपी प्रचंड बहुमत के साथ आ रही है विपक्ष पूरी तरह से दिग्भ्रमित है डिरेल्ड है कोई नीति और एजेंडा नहीं है जनता ने इन्हें बुरी तरह नकार दिया है
भाजपा को जनता ने बैठाया है और जनता ही बैठाना चाहती है और फिर एक बार मोदी सरकार बनाना चाहती है और इस बात को सारे विपक्षी नेता जानते हैं 400 पार फिर एक बार प्रचंड बहुमत की मोदी सरकार
One Gandhi sibling has already pulled out of the race. Will Rahul Gandhi take on the Amethi challenge? With Mausami Singh and Rahul Gautam in Delhi, Bureau Report, India Today.
And Congress cadre on the ground are also at this point have no clue whether they're going to see Rahul Gandhi contest from Amethi or not. We're getting in images of Congress workers sitting on a dharna at the Congress office in Amethi with the demand that Rahul Gandhi contest elections from Amethi. You can see on your screens that they've got posters in their hand, they're raising slogans, they're demanding that Rahul Gandhi return to Amethi. Now, they're saying that they're going to sit on a dharna till there's an announcement on who exactly the candidate will be. Remember that the Congress cadre are also completely in the dark, and while they're continuing to work on ground, they don't have a face really to fight for in Amethi. And let's bring in our reporters. Mausami Singh, who tracks the Congress closely for us, is joining us live from Delhi. We've also got Abhishek Mishra, who's been to Amethi and understands what's really the mood on the ground. Mausami, to you first. We had this exact same conversation yesterday, 24 hours later. Nothing's changed. There's still no announcement from the Congress. And this is clearly going to be extremely last minute. But what we're hearing now is that Priyanka Gandhi is not going to contest. Rahul Gandhi could choose between Amethi and Raibareli.
That's right, Akshita. You know, in fact, there is reluctance on behalf of Priyanka Gandhi, who believes that she's better off campaigning and concentrating across the country as far as rallies is concerned. And Rahul Gandhi, perhaps, is also sticking to this point that he's promised the people of Wayanad that he will be with them. So, in the dilemma where he wins both the constituencies, which one will he let go? And that is the dilemma that is stopping Rahul Gandhi from contesting two constituencies. So there is suspense over whether Rahul Gandhi will take the plunge in the north, in Amethi or Raibareli for that matter or not. And Mallikarjun Kharge, perhaps the ball was in his court. He has spoken to both the Gandhi siblings. We are told that it will take 24 hours or more, perhaps 24 hours, and within 24 hours, it will be clear what is the fate of Amethi and Rae Bareilly Congress's candidate.
Okay, within 24 hours, there should be clarity. Abhishek, what's the scene on ground in Amethi? You know, if an announcement is made within 24 hours, that's on May 1st, that gives essentially one extra day before the deadline for nomination filing actually goes ahead and comes to an end. Very, very little time also to campaign, to create any sort of presence on ground. Is that a factor really the Congress has to consider? Or is, you know, the Congress cadre on ground in Amethi that strong that a face doesn't matter?
Well, certainly, Akshita, in the sense of suspicion is getting, you know, more intense day by day, to be specific, hour by an hour, because we're expecting something by today, but nothing of that sort has happened. What is also very important is that the cadre on the ground is very keen that Rahul should come on the seat Amethi. They've seen the visuals, how there is a demand from the workers. They were expecting it, because a lot of us have already gone through for the preparation. As I told you, that internally they were making their minds, and not only that, the booth management, the committees, and at the block level, those work has already been finished. Now, things in a way are still, you know, in a confusion. Priyanka not willing to contest. She wants to focus on more on the campaigning to put the party on the map, and at the same time, you know, Rahul still apprehensive over it is not a good sign. So that is why the cadre is now getting more anxious about the fact that whether or not who is going to contest. And we also have to consider that the BJP is also still waiting for the announcement on Rae Bareilly. There also they have not given any face. So Rae Bareilly still is very confused, and voters are still wants to know that who they are going to vote for. So that is what is happening. But yes, we again have to wait for certain few hours.
That's an important point that you've raised. The fact that in Rae Bareilly, both the BJP and the Congress haven't announced a candidate so far. Smriti Irani and Amethi from the BJP. But it looks like the BJP is also waiting to see who will fight from Rae Bareilly to go ahead and announce their own candidate from the seat as well. So Rae Bareilly completely in the dark right now. Abhishek and Moshmi, thanks very much for joining us with those details. Let's just break down for you what really Rahul Gandhi will be weighing out is the pros and cons of fighting from Amethi, of returning to Amethi to kind of avenge his loss. Now, the pros will be that essentially you're energizing the Congress cadre on ground because you're sending out a message that you don't shy away from a challenge and that you want to correct the 2019 wrongs. The problem, however, is that this will be a last-minute announcement with no time to campaign. He'll be relying largely on the fact that this is a legacy bastion of the Gandhis in Amethi. It's also an opportunity to avenge the Amethi 2019 loss because you're going to see a repeat of what happened in 2019 in the sense that it will be Rahul versus Smriti again. So there will be an opportunity for him to do that again, which will send out a message to Congress cadre and to citizens and voters of the entire country. There is, however, a problem if Rahul Gandhi goes ahead and doesn't avenge the 2019 loss. It will be a serious blow to his credibility because Amethi then has been lost twice under his watch, in his name. So that's really a big, big con that he will be watching out for. And that's why perhaps the Congress is thinking, rethinking whether Rahul Gandhi should fight from the seat or not. Mallikarjun Kharge says an announcement is expected very, very soon. But largely we hear it's Rahul Gandhi who will take the final decision on whether he wants to take that plunge and fight in Amethi again or not. And let's also take a look back, recap for you why Amethi is so crucial for the Gandhis, the link that the Gandhis have had with the Amethi seat.
The climax of the Bharat Jodo Nyay Yatra, where Rahul Gandhi, who lost Amethi in 2019, is back in what was once the traditional bastion of the Gandhi family.
It was a rumbling homecoming of sorts. A king, if you will, who was vanquished from his own kingdom, returning on a yatra after 5 years.
लेंगे बदला देंगे खून भैया बिना अमेठी सुन क्योंकि अमेठी किसान अमेठी जान किसानों का मसीहा.
The message was unmistakable and yet filled with that traditional Congress intrigue.
Yeah.
often said that nothing can be taken for granted in politics, not bastions, not legacies, not strongholds. This would come true in 1998, when the Congress faced the brunt quite simply for complacency, as Amethi was lost to the Vajpayee wave that swept Uttar Pradesh.
But I think Sonia Gandhi was intelligent enough to realize that if she had to establish family control or her dominance over the Congress, she needed to win in North India and Amethi in particular. It would then signal that the baton had been passed in a way from Rajiv Gandhi, her late husband, to her.
And it was during this term, this was between 1999 to 2004, that a young and reclusive Rahul Gandhi emerged in public and appeared for campaigns in the shadow of his mother. The question was not if, but when.
You have to feel it. If you want to do it at the right time, you do it. I don't think pressure is really an issue. You can't really be pressurized.
But clearly, you are not the type who is averse to politics.
I'm not averse to politics, but that doesn't mean I'm going to join politics.
क्या आपको लगता है कि राहुल गांधी आप लोगों पर वही दबाव रहेगा कि राहुल को बड़ा संभाल के रखना होगा? राहुल पर भी सारी की चीजें हो सकती हैं. डर नहीं लगता है सब सोच?
डर तो नहीं लगता, डर नहीं लगता.
आपने अमेठी सीट क्यों छोड़ दी? रायबरेली से लड़ना क्यों ठीक समझ रही?
क्योंकि अमेठी एक क्षेत्र है जो राजीव जी का क्षेत्र था, और राहुल, क्योंकि राहुल चुनाव लड़ने का निर्णय लिया, तो सभी ने, हम लोग ने बातचीत किया और अपने परिवार के बीच में, और ये तय हुआ कि शायद अमेठी राहुल जी के लिए ठीक रहेगा.
अमेठी had really little option but to accept. After all, this was Rajiv's son and they felt indebted to the Gandhi parivar. Loved and adored, there was no match for Rahul, at least in terms of votes. But the opposition kept the dinnest charge on him all through, lining his rule of Amethi with derisive attacks that would run like a background score, essentially.
तो डायनेस्टी का बिल्कुल रिडिक्यूलस मुद्दा है.
आई बिलीव दैट दिस वर्ड इज इनकरेक्ट. दिस इज नॉट अ डायनेस्टी. वी हैव वन एंड वी हैव लॉस्ट डेमोक्रेटिक.
In the lead up to the 2014 elections, it was no longer a saffron wave. It was the Narendra Modi wave that was capturing the imagination of voters. And finally, after years, the Gandhi parivar had a heavy-hitting challenger. Cue Smriti Irani.
Rahul Gandhi's leadership is defined by the state of his constituency, which right now faces many challenges. He's out only when it's convenient for him. When he wants to fight in the election, when he wants to gain something for himself or his organization or his family. Naam ko to bada vote diya, ab kaam ko vote dijiye.
Smriti Irani fought tooth and nail against what the BJP had branded the Congress's Shehzada. But then Amethi was still a fortress and wasn't done with the Gandhis just yet. Even the massive Modi wave couldn't bring it down in 2014. Rahul retained the seat, but there was clear damage and a major drop in the victory margin. A moral victory for Smriti and an ominous foretelling of what would happen to Rahul here 5 years later.
It is unfortunate that it's unexpected in politics, that you would lose and you would still come back. But I had a promise to keep. Especially to 3 lakh people who voted for me in 20 days. For 3 lakh people to believe in you, that is a huge blessing. I can only say people with political resolve always jump into the fire. They don't run from it.
And in May 2019, that fortress fell. An epic face-off with Smriti Irani winning the seat by over 50,000 votes.
And to the Gandhi family, send Rahul Gandhi back to fight the Lok Sabha election in 2024 from Amethi and he will lose again. That is my promise as a BJP worker.
Well, here we are now in 2024.
Obviously, yesterday when the rally was taking place, I talked to a large number of people and they all said that we made a mistake in 2019. We want Rahul Gandhi back.
कोई कुछ लोग मेहमान लोग आया है वो चले जाएगा.
राहुल गांधी गांधी परिवार यहाँ का जनता के दिल में बसा है, वो हमेशा रहेगा।
सबसे उम्दा काम दीदी स्मृति ईरानी का रहा, 2014 के बाद जब यहाँ वो लड़ने आई, दुर्भाग्य से 2014 वो नहीं जीत पाई, लेकिन बराबर 5 साल 2019 तक वो लगातार यहाँ संपर्क में रही, हर महीने आती रही। 24 में तो और बड़े मतों से जीतने जा रहे हैं, जो कांग्रेस की हवा है वो तो निकल चुकी है पूरे देश से, जब 400 पार है तो उसमें अमेठी भी शामिल रहेगा।
So can Rahul Gandhi reclaim or even for that matter go ahead and fight for lost territory in Amethi? Will he take on Smriti Irani? Well, we'll know soon enough. All these questions will continue. But the answer at the end of the day, as always, lies in India's bristling election vote. It's a big showdown over Amit Shah's doctored video on caste quota that was being shared widely by political opponents of the BJP. Now, several Congress leaders are facing heat because of the investigation by the Delhi police. The BJP has pinned the blame on the Congress, with Amit Shah in a press conference today in Guwahati claiming that Rahul Gandhi is himself responsible for this propaganda being spread. Shah said that Congress is scared that it will lose these elections and that's why it's stooping to these lows. The Delhi police, in the meanwhile, has extended its investigation to several states. You've got fresh FIRs being filed, fresh arrests also being made. Three people in all have been arrested, and this includes Jignesh Mevani's PA. Another person who's been arrested is from the Aam Aadmi Party. You've got several Congress and Samajwadi Party leaders who've been called in for questioning as well. But the biggest fissure of the lot is the fact that the Delhi police has also summoned Telangana Chief Minister Revanth Reddy. He's been asked to appear before the Delhi police tomorrow on May 1st. Failing which, the Delhi police says we'll approach the court. Revanth Reddy, however, has dismissed this as a political conspiracy and an attempt to arrest him.
कई सारे वीडियोस आते हैं जो डीप फेक बन जाते हैं, क्या आपको लगता है कि लोगों को सतर्क रहना चाहिए डीप फेक वीडियोस को लेके?
देखिए, हमारी ओर से एक भी नहीं आया है, तीन आए, तीनों तीन कांग्रेस ने करे, यही बताता है कांग्रेस जन समर्थन के अभाव में इस प्रकार के गलत प्रचार के लिए पड़ी, वो उनकी हार की हताशा की निशानी है।
उनकी हताशा निराशा इस स्तर पर पहुंच गई है कि उन्होंने मेरा और कुछ भाजपा नेताओं का फेक वीडियो बनाकर सबके बीच में सार्वजनिक किया। मुख्यमंत्री, प्रदेश अध्यक्ष, इस कक्षा के व्यक्तियों ने भी इस फेक वीडियो को फॉरवर्ड करने का काम किया। अब स्पष्ट हो चुका है, सौभाग्य से मैं जो बोला था उसका भी रिकॉर्डिंग हुआ था, तो वो रिकॉर्ड हमने सबके सामने रखा, दूध का दूध पानी का पानी हो गया और आज कांग्रेस पार्टी के प्रमुख नेता क्रिमिनल ऑफेंस को फेस कर रहे हैं। ये जो कृत्य है वो उनकी हताशा और निराशा का द्योतक है। जब से राहुल गांधी कांग्रेस की कमान संभाले हैं, राजनीति का स्तर नीचे 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 ले जाने का काम कर रहे हैं और ये इसका चरम। लोकसभा में चर्चा न हो देना, राज्यसभा में बहिष्कार करा देना, शोर शराबे करना और निराधार झूठ बोलकर प्रजा में भ्रांति फैलाने का काम लगातार उनके नेतृत्व में कांग्रेस पार्टी कर रही है। और मैं मानता हूं कि अब फेक वीडियो सर्कुलरेट कर फर्जी टाइप का जनसमर्थन प्राप्त करने का ये प्रयास ये बहुत निंदनीय है और भारतीय राजनीति में किसी प्रमुख दल के द्वारा कभी ऐसा नहीं किया गया।
इट इज अ शेमलेस, डिसग्रेसफुल, पैथेटिक एक्ट ऑफ द कांग्रेस पार्टी, अ पार्टी दैट टुडे इज हेडेड बाय राहुल गांधी, हु हैज नो आइडिया फॉर द फ्यूचर ऑफ इंडिया, हु हैज डन नथिंग बट लूट एंड करप्ट द स्टेट्स दैट दे आर गवर्नमेंट इन। दे हैव नो आइडिया फॉर द चेंज इंप्रूवमेंट ऑफ एनी इंडियन सिटीजन्स लाइफ। दे आर रिड्यूस्ड टुडे टू सेइंग लाइज, to misleading people through deep fakes and through appeasement politics. This video is a symbol of where the Congress party is in today's India. They have nothing positive to say, they have no truth to offer, they have only a politics that depends on their lies.
Isme do vishay hai, ek janta ke beech mein reservation ke naam par aapas mein danga karwane ke liye prayas kiya, ek number 2 एक होम मिनिस्टर का वीडियो को मार्फिंग करके ऑफिशियल हैंडल से पोस्ट करना, ये दो अलग अलग विषय, इस दो विषय पर कार्रवाई होना चाहिए। मेरा डिमांड हुई है, हम इस विषय पर हम कोर्ट को भी जाने वाला है, कोर्ट में भी खड़गरा में मुख्यमंत्री जो उनका पार्टी को खड़ा करेंगे।
आई एम टेलिंग यू दे आर नॉट ओनली मिसयूजिंग, इवन टुडे दे हैव इश्यूड अ नोटिस टू मी आल्सो, बट वी आर शॉर्ट अ टाइम, वी विल सी दैट, बट दे आर थ्रेटनिंग, दे आर मिसयूजिंग सीसी इलेक्शन कमीशन, दे आर मिसयूजिंग the other their financial agencies, therefore they are not allowing us to have a level playing ground, therefore this election they don't want to give the level playing ground, they want to play the, on their own ways.
And let's play out for you what exactly the doctored clip of Amit Shah looks like that was spread widely on social media versus the actual video.
ये जनता पार्टी की सरकार बनेगी तो एक गैर संवैधानिक एससी एसटी और ओबीसी का है वो रिजर्वेशन को हम समाप्त कर देंगे, रिजर्वेशन को हम समाप्त कर देंगे। भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार बनेगी तो एक गैर संवैधानिक मुस्लिम रिजर्वेशन को हम समाप्त कर देंगे, ये अधिकार तेलंगाना के एससी एसटी और ओबीसी का है वो अधिकार उनको मिलेगा और मुस्लिम रिजर्वेशन को हम समाप्त कर देंगे।
Let's take this across to our reporters on the ground. Shreya Chatterjee is joining us live from Delhi. We have Abdul Bashir from Hyderabad. Abdul, to you first on what action really has been taken in Hyderabad. Revanth Reddy being summoned, issued a notice to appear before the Delhi police tomorrow. Is he going to heed that notice? Is he going to give them a response?
Well, what we are hearing is that five members from the TPCC have received this summons, like notice from the Delhi police after an FIR had been registered. An FIR in which the sections imposed or charged were 153 and 153A. And also this from the IPC and also from the Information Technology Act as well. So after the FIR was registered, five members from TPCC, including TPCC Chief Revanth Reddy, was given this notice. Four had received from Gandhi Bhavan, Manne Satish, Naveen, Shivashankar and Asma Taslim. These are the four members, one of them which was heading the social media team. Manne Satish was the first one to be given this notice, and then TPCC Chief Revanth Reddy was sent an email by the Delhi police, is what we are getting to know. Now tomorrow they have to appear before the Delhi police with the gadget that we used for posting this doctored, allegedly posting this doctored video that went viral. So now after this case has been registered, now Revanth Reddy yesterday in a rally has responded that he's ready to fight, he's ready to give a response, and it is to be seen as to where will Revanth Reddy tomorrow in person going to appear before the Delhi police, or will they be, will they seek time as this is the election movement that is going on. All his schedule has been planned, he's doing yatras all over the state, not only over the state but also in the southern states as well. It is to be seen whether Revanth Reddy will seek time
with regards to the summon that's been issued. There's been no response from Revanth Reddy to that summon, clarifying on whether he'll appear tomorrow or, for that matter, seeking more time. Shreya Chatterjee is joining us live with more details of the Delhi police's investigation. It isn't limited to Telangana alone, Shreya. We've seen one arrest in Assam. There have been a few more with Jignesh Mevani's PA, with an ARP leader also reportedly being arrested. How big is this investigation? How far is it spread?
But right now what the Delhi police is investigating primarily is understanding the entire trail of this particular case, where the origination started. And remember, the primary reason why we are seeing the Telangana Congress and Revanth Reddy in the dock is because the video was shared by the Twitter handle of the Telangana Congress. Primarily, that's the reason why Delhi police had actually summoned the three members of the Telangana कांग्रेस कमेटी एंड allegedly the CM of Telangana as well tomorrow whether he or not they will appear is something that we'll have to wait and watch for. But Delhi police has already written to social media platform both X and Facebook to unearth the entire trail that was behind the circulation of this video and also the creation and then subsequently the entire role and the modus operandi.
All right, Shreya and Abdul, thanks very much for getting us all of those details. Let's cut across to another story, and this is a big one that we've been tracking closely from Karnataka, the Hasan sex tape controversy. JDS now under massive pressure announced the suspension of Prajwal Revanna until the completion of the SIT probe, saying that if the SIT investigation finds him to be guilty, then he will be expelled permanently from the party. They've made it clear that they are for justice and they want the investigation to move forward. Let's get you all the details in our next report. Prajwal Revanna sex tape row explodes. The Janata Dal Secular has suspended former Prime Minister and Party President H.D. Devegowda's grandson Prajwal until the completion of the SIT probe.
ನೀವೇನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ, ಎಷ್ಟು ದಿವಸದವರೆಗೆ ಅಮಾನತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಸಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು? ಇದು ಸೊಸೈಟಿಯ ತನಿಖೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಜ್ವಲ್ ಅವರ ಪಾತ್ರ ಏನಿದೆ ಅಂತಕ್ಕಂಥ ವರದಿ ಬರೋವರೆಗೂ ಸಸ್ಪೆನ್ಷನ್ ಇದೆ. ತಪ್ಪಿತಸ್ಥ ಅಂತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ವರದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಾಗ ಪರ್ಮನೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಸಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ.
Protests over the videos erupted in Bengaluru and Hubballi, where a scuffle broke out between Congress and JDS workers. The sex tapes, allegedly featuring Prajwal Revanna, were shared widely ahead of voting in his constituency, Hasan. There are many claims around who leaked these videos. BJP leader Devaraja Gowda, who had warned the state party leadership against Prajwal Revanna, has pointed fingers at Karnataka Deputy Chief Minister D.K. Shivkumar and his brother D.K. Suresh.
उसका कार ड्राइवर मेरे पास आया था. मैं पूछा उसको, आपके पास क्या है, क्या मटेरियल्स, क्या है एविडेंस, क्या है? मैं पूछा मैं. वो जब बोला वो सब मेरे पास सभी वीडियो है. मैं पूछा मैं ये वीडियो सब किसी को दिया क्या? वो बोला हाँ दे दिया. वो किसको दिया? वो कांग्रेस पार्टी का एक नेता और पार्टी प्रेसिडेंट मिस्टर डी के शिवकुमार, डी के सुरेश दोनों को भी दिया.
Prajwal Revanna's driver has however denied the claim by BJP's Devaraja Gowda.
ಮತ್ತೆ ಅವರ ಈ ಪೆನ್ಡ್ರೈವ್ ನ ಕಾರ್ತಿಕ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನನಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟ, ಮತ್ತೆ ನಾನು ಬರೋಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮುಂಚೆನೆ ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಮುಖಂಡರಿಗೆಲ್ಲ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಸುಳ್ಳು ಸುಳ್ಳು ಅಪಾದನೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡ್ತಾವ್ರೆ. ಬಟ್ ಏನಂತಾರೆ, ನಾನು ಬಿಜೆಪಿ ಮುಖಂಡರಾದಂತ ಮುನೇಶ್ವರ ಕ್ಯಾಂಡಿಡೇಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೀವಿ, ಪರಾಜಿತ ಅಭ್ಯರ್ಥಿ ಆದ ದೇವರಾಜೇಗೌಡರು ಬಿಟ್ರೆ.
ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಲೀಡರ್ ಡಿ ಕೆ ಸುರೇಶ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡಿಸ್ಮಿಸ್ ದ ಚಾರ್ಜ್.
ದಿಸ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫೋಟೋಸ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಔಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ 2019. This is the issue of after he became MP, he misuses his office. In his office only he has done all this, so many cases in his office only, in where Hasan district office is there. There he has done it, and in his residence and his farmhouse and other places.
The scandal has become a flashpoint in the middle of a heated Lok Sabha election campaign.
Karnataka mein ek bahut badi baat nikli hai. कि उनके साथ जो मंच पे खड़े थे, जिनके लिए मोदी जी ने वोट मांगा, उन्होंने हजारों महिलाओं के साथ दुष्कर्म किया, हजारों महिलाओं के साथ. मैं पूछना चाहती हूँ मोदी जी क्या कहते हैं इसके बारे में, क्या कहते हैं हमारे प्रधानमंत्री इसके बारे में?
नरेंद्र मोदी जी का पूरे देश को एक कमिटमेंट है कि कहीं पर भी मातृशक्ति के अपमान को सहन नहीं किया जाना. परंतु कांग्रेस पार्टी जो हम पर आरोप लगाना चाहती है, मैं छोटी सी बात पूछना चाहता हूं, वहां सरकार किसकी है? सरकार कांग्रेस पार्टी की है, फेक वीडियो आपके ध्यान में ही होंगे क्योंकि टाइम पर रिलीज किए गए हैं, और अब तक कार्यवाही कांग्रेस पार्टी ने क्यों नहीं की?
While the political war over the sex tapes escalates, the man at the center of it, Prajwal Revanna, is in Europe, where he claims to be on a tour. With Sagar Raj, Anaga Keshav and Nagarjun Dwarkanath in Bengaluru, Euro Report, India Today.
Even as questions are asked as to exactly where Prajwal Revanna is, India Today has reached out to the German police. Reports are suggesting that Prajwal is currently in Germany and fled there as soon as this case came to light. But German cops confirmed to us here on India Today that there is no inquiry from Indian authorities about Prajwal Revanna's whereabouts. So there is no attempt to bring him back, at least at this point of the investigation. Ashutosh Mishra is joining us with more details on this. Ashutosh, you reached out to the German authorities. What exactly did they convey to you?
Well, the reaction which has come from the Frankfurt Federal Police Department, which has told India Today that we are not aware of the facts and we haven't received any inquiry from the Indian authorities, and we have no knowledge of whether such inquiries have been made out to even the other German authorities as far as Prajwal Revanna's whereabouts is concerned. Remember, there are reports that he would have probably fled to Frankfurt in parts of Germany or probably headed towards the Netherlands. So on that note, I tried to reach out to several authorities, and there is a response which is coming from the Federal Police Department of Frankfurt, which have rather said, in fact, there are the legal codes that are available to the agency that they reach out to the Interpol via CBI or issue for the non-bailable warrants, and that the procedure follows. So clearly the lookout notice that was required, and since before it was issued, reportedly Prajwal Revanna fled from India. So clearly as far as his presence in Germany is concerned, the Frankfurt Federal Police Department says we do not have any information about him, nor there are any queries they have received from the Indian authorities. So clearly, as and when the Indian authorities reach out to the Frankfurt police or the other federal departments of Germany, clearly there will be the hunt down begins. Especially, remember, the Europe or European nations, they show literally zero tolerance towards such crime against women. So clearly on that, if we see issues are raised with the Frankfurt or maybe German authorities, clearly there will be some action.
Sure.
But so far,
there will have to be an outreach, of course, from Indian authorities for any sort of action or for them to give clarity on where exactly Prajwal is. Thanks very much, Ashutosh, for those details. News coming in of an FIR being registered against Salman Khurshid's niece Maria Alam Khan over her vote jihad remark. The SP candidate from Farrukhabad has now been booked for controversial speech. Remember, she had said and called for a social boycott of Muslims who vote for the BJP. Now, it's not just her, but Salman Khurshid, who's also been named in the FIR. So his name has also been mentioned in the FIR based on a complaint that's been lodged against the both of them. Maria Alam Khan, during the course of her campaign, made this comment saying that any Muslim who votes for the BJP must face a social boycott. The BJP has lashed out at the SP leader and at Salman Khurshid, resharing essentially a 2016 video where he speaks about Muslim reservation. And with that news break, I'm wrapping up this edition of Election Express. Thanks very much for tuning in.